What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and today Apple released iOS 14.7 almost 2 months after the release of iOS 14.6. Now, in addition to this iOS release, we also got iPadOS 14.7, watchOS 7.6, macOS Big Sur 11.5, tvOS 14.7, and HomePodOS 14.7. But of course, in this video, we're talking all about iOS and iPadOS 14.7 and what all is new, along with the performance, the battery life, and more. Now, taking a look at the size of this update, you can see here, it came in just under 1 gigabyte on my iPhone 12 here. It came in at 915 megabytes, but of course, that size will vary depending on your device and the version you're coming from. Now, also, if you are on the RC build, if you're running the betas of iOS 14, you might need to delete the beta profile to see iOS 14.7 show up on your device. So anyways, let's go ahead and move on to the build number and the modem. So if you go to our settings and to general and then to about and then tap on 14.7, you can see the build number is going to be either 18G68 or 18G69. So if you scroll down a little bit to the modem firmware, you can see that the modem has also received an update. It's now 1.80.02. So if you were having any connectivity issues or just issues related to the modem, you could see those fixed thanks to this update. So now what's new here in iOS 14.7? And the first thing is compatibility with the new MagSafe battery pack for the iPhone 12. So this is the new product Apple just released, and iOS 14.7 adds compatibility for this new battery pack. Also new in iOS 14.7 is Apple Card family support. So if you have kids or a significant other that you want to share your Apple Card with, whether that's to build credit together or just track expenses, whatever the case may be, you can now do that. So when you open up the wallet application, you will see this card right once you open it up. If you tap on Get Started, it says, share your Apple Card with members of your family sharing group. Track spending, pay a single bill, build credit together, and receive daily cash. If you tap on continue, this is how you add somebody in. You have to invite the person. So if you invite people to family sharing right here, of course, they will already show up if you have them in family sharing, but if not, you can invite like so. You can send them a link via AirDrop or messages, or you can invite in person right here. So if the person's right beside you, they can just enter in their Apple ID and password right there, and you will be on your way. Also new in iOS 14.7, we now have the ability to add and manage timers for the HomePod. So you can see right here, I have my Office HomePod right here. If I have to press on that, you can see down here, we have a timers section. That did not used to be there. And from here, we can set multiple timers. Like if I want to set a timer for 1 hour, I can do that. Just press start right there. I can also tap on new and start a timer for 1 minute and start it right there. And you can see the countdown of the timers right there on the HomePod. And then when the timer goes off, this is the noise you'll hear. So that's what the timer sounds like. And of course, you can just go ahead and cancel these timers right here with just a tap of a button. So you can now manage and add timers inside the home application for your HomePod instead of having to ask Siri to do it. Also new in iOS 14.7, if we go to the podcast application and then to the library tab and then to shows, you can see that we now have this section off by followed and all. So before, this is iOS 14.6 on the left, we did not have a sorting option up there. It just kind of just showed all of our shows no matter what. But now in 14.7, it shows the shows that you're following and also all shows right here. So like for example, Oddball is showing up under all because I downloaded one episode, but I'm not following that podcast. So it does not show up under followed. It only shows up under all. So there are now sorting options here in the podcast library tab under shows here in 14.7. Now, one of the main issues that has been fixed here in iOS 14.7 is a fix for the Apple Music 15 second bug. So this is very popular over the past couple of months. A lot of people had this issue where if they had Dolby Atmos enabled or lossless audio enabled, they could only play like 15 seconds of a song before it would just pause or it would just give them like an error message. But that has been fixed here in iOS 14.7. And then also some people had an issue where they could not share their playlist. Like if you went into playlist right here and you tapped and held right here and you have the share playlist menu option right there. So some people did not have that in 14.6, but that has also been resolved here in 14.7. You can share your playlist, that link is back. Another resolved issue in iOS 14.7 is that the battery service message on iPhone 11s, the iPhone 11 series, so this is the 11 Pro Max. And if you had any type of battery, you know, service message up top or anything about the recalibration right there, that would disappear after a reboot and not show up again. But that's been fixed, and now it stays there even after a reboot. We also have some updates to weather for certain countries. So the air quality index has now been added to both weather and maps. So the air quality right here under weather, and then also in maps in the bottom right hand corner of maps, you now get air quality index for Canada, France, Italy, Netherlands, South Korea, and Spain. We also have a fix for Braille displays showing invalid information while composing mail messages. So that has been resolved here in 14.7. And then the final thing that's been resolved in 14.7, which is a pretty big one, is the Wi-Fi bug. So if we go back to our Wi-Fi right here and then go to Wi-Fi, if the SSID on previous versions, like iOS 14.6 and previous, had a percent sign in that SSID and you connected to it, it could brick your Wi-Fi settings completely and you would not be able to connect to Wi-Fi again unless you reset your settings. So that has been resolved here in 14.7. That bug no longer exists. And as far as green tint goes, iOS 14.7 appears to fix green tint for some users. So some people with the iPhone 12 series have been having the green tint issue ever since the iPhone 12 came out, and iOS 14.7 appears to fix that even more. So it seems like it's getting better just progressively with every software update, and it seems like iOS 14.7 is further fixing the green tint issue, although some people are saying it's still there, but it's just not as bad as it was when they first got their phone. Now, as far as the performance goes, the performance feels very smooth here. It feels very good. I mean, we have been in the beta stages for quite a while, so you would expect it to be very stable and run very well, which it does. Now, I don't know if it's that much faster than iOS 14.6. It does seem a little bit better and a little bit smoother just because of the bug fixes, but just overall raw performance, it feels about the same as iOS 14.6. Now, if I go ahead and run a Geekbench test here for iOS 14.7, I will show you guys what I score. So you can see we got a 1594 on the single core and a 4036 on the multi-core. So not bad on the Geekbench scores. Of course, they don't always tell the full story. They usually don't tell the full story, but it is kind of just interesting to see what every version scores as far as that test goes. Now, as far as battery life goes, this is one area where 14.7 is going to shine because a lot of people had battery drain issues on 14.6, even on 14.5, but 14.7 should resolve a lot of the battery drain issues, especially on newer devices. So some people have battery drain issues even on the iPhone 12 and even the iPhone 11 series. So iOS 14.7 should resolve those issues. The battery life has been great here on 14.7, and I would expect that since 14.7 is going to be one of the final iOS 14 versions before iOS 15 comes out. It's not going to be the final one, I don't believe, which we'll talk about here in a moment, but it is going to be one of the final iOS 14 releases. So battery life should be good, and fortunately, it is here on 14.7. So now let's go ahead and talk about what is next for Apple, because I do think that an iOS 14.7.1 or a 14.8 will be coming very, very soon. Now, if it's 14.8, it'll likely go through beta testing. But if it's 14.7.1, it's likely going to be just a public release without any beta testing necessary. Now, we still do have a couple of months to go before Apple releases iOS 15 sometime here, probably in mid-September. So we do have a couple of months to go before iOS 15 gets released. So I would expect at least one, probably two more iOS 14 releases until September. So just keep that in mind. You don't have to be on iOS 15 betas at this point. You could go back to iOS 14 and you'll be just fine. So that's what you can expect for the future of iOS 14 releases. So anyways, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 14.7, a nice update with a lot of pretty big fixes. So we have the battery drain fix. We have a fix for the Apple Music 15-second bug, the Wi-Fi fix, and some nice changes as well here in 14.7. So definitely recommend updating. I would recommend updating no matter what version you're on. And if you're on iOS 15 and it's running, you know, pretty bad, if you're having bugs, I would recommend downgrading to 14.7 because the performance and the battery life will be significantly better. And I did post a tutorial on how to downgrade if you want to do that. I will leave that link in the description below. But if you guys enjoyed this video, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss my future iOS 14 and iOS 15 coverage here on the channel. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.